Howdy ding on duty, guys, welcome back to Let's Play Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney, Justice for All.
With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, we continued our investigation into the murder of a ringmaster. And today we're gonna keep on with our investigation, and we're gonna present something we found in the cafeteria to Mo. This broken bottle.
What do you think about this? Anything come to mind?
You're washing my bash on your development as a comedian, right? I see. Well, this is what you do. When you tell a joke, imagine everyone's wearing underwear and dancing with them better.
I think that's enough advice for now.
He was giving you good advice. Don't be so close-minded.
Okay, so it's not that. Or maybe we go back to... Max Galactica. Shall we try that? I think that'd be a good...
Just show this ball to damn everyone.
Okay.
Oh, here we go. December 28th, Detention Center. Visitor's room.
No! Stop throwing cards at me, you jerk!
Oh, it's my two sweeties. Welcome to the Detention Center.
You just call me a sweetie. Again.
What's on today's agenda? What can I help you with?
Well, we've got quite a few clues.
No! Wonderfully fantabuloso! I mean fabulous.
That's why we came to meet with you again.
What's wrong? Quit making such a scary face.
Okay then, Max. Let's make this absolutely fabulous.
Okay.
Behold! What about this?
Fabulous. You'd like me to sign this for you?
What? God damn it, man, it's not clear what I really want to be doing here. Maybe if I present this clown guy.
Behold. What about this person?
Fortunately, I don't take on apprentices. I mean, just look at their face on this one. So what I'd call fabulous.
It's awfully harsh.
This guy?
I can't believe a guy with that ugly mug is after my sweetie pie princess. Especially after she has eluded my charms for such a long time.
There isn't much you can do about that, right?
You haven't even been truly in love, have you? When you are truly in love with someone, you'll be jealous of their memory because it traps their image inside.
Don't you think that's sweet of him, Nick?
I'm gonna get back with this with my sweetie pie. Then I'm gonna turn that dumb puppet into a toy glider.
I keep losing the voice, I apologize.
I guess you two haven't worked out your differences yet.
Okay. Wait, what? I thought we'd done all this.
We heard a lot about you at the circus, Max.
Ah, you must meet from the dinosaurs. How are those Jurassic geriatrics?
Geriatrics?
Max, you're not very popular with the other performers, are you?
Yes, 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 sweetie. That's why they call it jealousy. J-E-A-L-O-U-I-S-T-Y-P-V-W. They're absolutely jealous of my absolutely fabulous self. People who really understand can't see the obvious differences between us.
People who really understand?
For instance, my sweetie pie.
So Regina understands him, huh?
I plan on getting married to her. She's truly my sweetie pie princess.
Wow, that's so cool.
It's already in the works.
That's strange. Regina never said anything about marrying this joker. You met with the ringmaster on the night of the murder.
Yes, I was around 10 PM once I was done with practice. I went to his room right after we finished.
I found the ringmaster's body in the plaza in front of a lodging house.
Yeah, I heard about that. He needed to step out for a bit, so I waited in his room for him to return.
Huh?
Okay.
Sorry, Max, I have something I must attend to right now. Do you mind waiting for me right here?
It's pretty cold outside. Where's your coat?
It's alright, I'll be right back. It should only take about 10 minutes.
Okay.
And then?
I waited for him, but he never came back.
Did he go to the plaza where the body was discovered?
Possibly. Possibly. The snow had tapered off a bit, but it was still very cold outside. But you have no idea what he went off to do.
Okay.
When you make absolutely fabulous magic, it costs enormous sums of money, sums that will boggle your mind.
Okay. I'm just gonna use the maggot armor on this guy and see if I can break through to him. Okay. Right.
No! Behold! My Yu-Gi-Oh hand, where I break my wrist to draw a card.
Behold. Let's see if we can break through any of this stuff. We might need more evidence though, so I'm going to be a bit cautious. And if I don't see a clear way through, then I'll go back to the circus.
Last night, you met with a ringmaster, correct? To negotiate your salary and such.
Exactly, we reached an agreement about the salary from my 6-month-old contract.
That's the truth, the whole truth.
What do you mean?
You just went to his office to negotiate your new salary.
I hate lies, and I hate lies even more. What are you insinuating? Do you have any proof that I did something other than negotiate my fee last night?
He got a raise 1 week ago, man. Just 3 famous symbols. Mace, Aura, Fedora. Let me just try this. It might not work.
What?
It was on the table in the ringmaster's room. You weren't lying when you said that you received quite a raise.
Is there a problem with being well compensated?
Not with a compensation, just with a date. This is dated a week ago. Max, you finished your contract negotiations a week ago.
Fabulous.
Ah.
Alright, I'll tell you the truth. That night, the ringmaster called me into his room.
Called you? Why did he do that?
Sorry, sweetie. That's private.
The ringmaster called him. For some sort of problem. Max, perhaps you could share with me what you two spoke about.
Well, not if I don't have to.
Well, I get a feeling it might have something to do with bashing that guy on the head during practice, or in the cafeteria, or whatever. Shall I just present this and see what happens?
Isn't this why you were called to the ringmaster's room that night?
Where did you get that?
Cafeteria. Jordan knew that, didn't you?
Oh, of course.
Alright, one more.
It fell and broke on the floor.
He's still hiding something else, Max.
What is it, my sweetie?
You use this bottle to
hit this guy on the head.
Behold!
Ben!
You nailed him over the head with this bottle, didn't you?
Yeah, that's a slump, mate. You can't do that.
That's why you got called to the ringmaster's room that night.
Fabulous! You might as well be a magician!
Okay, tell me your dirty secrets and stop throwing your fucking cards everywhere.
The guy's in the back like, stop making a mess! I have to clean this shit up! Okay, let's talk. Meeting with Russell.
The truth is, yesterday morning during breakfast, we had a run-in.
You mean you had a fight with Ben the Ventriloquist?
You could put it that way.
Why did you fight with him? Ben seems like such a quiet man.
We thought about my sweetie pie.
You mean Regina?
That ill-bred creep told my sweetie pie princess that he was in love with her. Would you put up with that?
Ill-bred? Are you talking about the same Ben?
Told he was in love with her? I assure this is the Ben we're talking about.
All I can say is that he made me mad and I had to tap him on his hard head. That's when the ringmaster called me and I realized that it was my chance.
Your chance?
So I went to his room and I laid it all out on the table. I asked him to let me marry my sweetie pie.
What?
The ringmaster told me that it sounds good to be. No! So my sweetie pie is my sweetie pie. And no one else's.
I see.
Since Ben was causing me so much trouble, I realized I had to shut him up.
Shut him up?
Well, sounds like you're trying to kill him or something.
What do you mean by shut him up?
You don't know, do you, my sweeties? Unless Ben and Trilo are together, Trilo can't say a word.
Trilo?
The puppet, the ventriloquist puppet. His real name is Trilo Quist.
Trilo Quist. Ben Trilo Quist. I love this game with its names.
But a puppet doesn't talk.
I know, that's why I hid it. The former priest came and took me away, of course. If that puppet started flapping off at the balsa, I'd be screwed.
You hid him? You mean a ventriloquist puppet?
You are so smart, sweetie.
Where did you hide him?
What, sweetie? You aren't thinking of trying to add him to my defense, are you?
Well, Ben does seem awfully lonely without his puppets.
No, fabulous! I should have taught him a lesson. Okay, hit Trilo in the ringmaster's room. You don't mind going there and getting Trilo for me, do you, my sweets?
No problem, not at all. Thank you, Max.
You know, I can't start to see my sweeties in a jam.
Then no go hiding, puppets!
Okay, that's our next objective then.
See you later, nerd.
Oh, hello.
December 28th, very big circus. Circus entrance.
Huh? Ben's not here anymore.
Yeah, I wanted to ask him something.
He's called out. He's probably in the tent.
Okay. Into the tent then.
December 28th, very big circus. Big top.
What do you think, Nick? I wonder if we've been making any progress.
Don't be so negative. Of course we're making progress.
But everyone left the ringmaster. There is no sign of footprints on the scene. There's still a lot of mysteries left to be solved.
Of course.
And now Regina isn't here.
I'm not seeing how that's related.
Are they off making a hanky-panky or something? To the ringmaster's room.
December 28th. Big top. Ringmaster's room.
Was that the same as always? A great big mess. Considering how messy it is, I bet they wouldn't notice if another poster went missing.
We're gonna stop it, you poster pilferer.
God, Maya's such a kleptomaniac, isn't she?
I'm just kidding. You know, I already got one of those posters.
You mean stole one of those posters?
Yeah, those folks are what Max told us. He said that he hit Trilo somewhere in this room.
Trilo? Oh, a ventriloquist puppet.
Okay, first things first. Can we get that without stealing it again? No, I want to know what's on that paper. It might be important. Okay, is it in the desk?
This is strange. Everything else looks nice, but this desk, it's all cheap. And all this stuff I've said before.
What's in here? Okay, there we go.
There's something shoved over the bookshelf. This is...
That's Trilo! That's Ben's puppet!
I think you're right. We'll give it back to him later.
Why do I have to carry this thing?
Well, you like it. Jesus. Man, it is because it does that blink with a scrap of paper. I get a feeling that's going to be important. I'll keep it in mind. Okay. So let's... Do we need to give this back to Ben, or... Or can we go take it back to the detention center and Max will say something?
Stop dropping cards on the fucking floor.
Okay, this...
This punker! Trilo is such a wooden, cheeky excuse for a puppet. I can't believe that this thing is what I'm up against for Regina's love. Ah, my sweetie pie. Love only me.
Oh, what? You're up against what for Regina's love?
Whatever, let's open and give this thing back to Ben.
Okay, if we can find it, maybe he's gone into Mo's room. Okay, or is he in the cafeteria? Said he might have gone into the tent, which makes sense if he's gone into the cafeteria.
Ah, there we go. December 28th, big top, cafeteria.
Oh, hey, Ben!
Hello.
Hello, Too-Too. It's awfully cold today, don't you agree?
Yeah, I do indeed.
Don't you think it's cold, Nick?
I don't see how talking about the weather is helping our case.
Yo, I've got your friend back. I think. Behold.
Ah, Ben, this is yours, isn't it?
Yes, that's mine.
Here you go.
Trilo Quist returned to Ben.
All right, mate, let's get going.
It's that time, isn't it? See you around, Ben.
Okay.
So, Nick, where are we going next?
Let's see, maybe we should go talk to the clowns again.
Hey, wait! Who said that? What are you looking at? I'm right here, you blind wench! What's your problem anyways? Don't you know how to probably greet someone? Ben? Is that you, Ben?
No, I would never.
It was me! Yeah, me, down here!
You're Trilo?
That's Mr. Quist to you, sir. Learn some manners before you just blurt out my name. Now try speaking to me again, but this time with some proper respect.
Not again. Mr. Quist, is that better?
No. Look at me when I'm talking to you, you 8-bit excuse for an attorney.
Trilo, we talked about insulting people. You promised.
But he was mocking me. Paying me to bullies was not included in the deal.
I'm sorry, Trilo.
What just happened? Trilo's still a puppet, right? And then Trilo's... Hey, who do you think you're calling me a puppet?
Okay. What happened? Tell us what you know about the murder.
You're talking to me? I said you're talking to me! Don't look at him while you're talking to me!
Trilo, Quist, you behave, young man.
Shut up, Woody! What murder are you talking about? You mean the one where they offer you, old man? I guess so. No need to make such a fuss about things. We are butt paid as all peanuts.
Trilo, you can't say things like that. I didn't raise you to be that kind of puppet.
Don't you have nerve pulls or something to take right now? These two are really not a couple, aren't they, Nick? Okay, I'll talk. Gramps got clobbered over the head.
By who?
Let me lay it all out for you. The pace sucks, the clown sucks, and my partner has his hands on my pants. Your partner? You mean Ben? Yeah, the creepy old guy who never fancied himself to leave me alone. Tell him to back off from me, would ya? He's just another one of the dorks around here. Oh, my. But I'll be fair. In this cesspool of human garbage masquerading as circus performers, I found my Madonna. Madonna?
Madonna?
Regina! My lovely Regina! She's standing right, Ben!
But I'm not sure if I would go that far.
You'll have to excuse him! It's the stand of what he speaks! I, on the other hand, am an appreciator of true beauty! That's why I shall marry her! Marry?
Jesus! She's a popular one!
The ringmaster got knocked upside his cheap head by that flying fraud!
You mean Maskalatka? I do say that.
Trilo, straighten up. Don't accuse people like that.
Straighten up? I'm made of wood. Besides, you were there. You know what happened.
You were there?
If you're that interested, then I'll let you in on the facts. You're going to marry Regina? That's right. She doesn't quite realize the joy that awaits her, does she?
Well, she did seem a bit worried about things.
Well, she...
I don't care, it is my choice, not hers. We're getting hitched.
I know you think that, but...
But what?
I gave her a special gift. I gave her a wonderful gift, a song. You gave her a song? Well, I am a renowned tenor. You'll be happy to know that I've decided to grace you with one of my songs.
Me.
I want you to touch me. I want you to kiss me. I want you to... The rest is private. Fucking perverts! Well, the melody is pretty good.
Those lyrics. The medieval work.
Who asked you? I'm the artist here.
Thanks. Now that Trilo's here.
Now that Trilo's here. Does that mean you can talk normally now?
Hey, buffface! You must be looking forward to tomorrow, aren't you, Mr. Ambulance Chaser? You know, it's time to get rid of our pesky magician once and for all. Trilo? Enough jibber-jabber! Let's get to court already!
Quit your jibber-jabber! Hey, wait a second!
Nick, what's going on?
He's a witness for tomorrow's trial.
And that
is where I'm going to end it, because Jesus, my... He has thoroughly destroyed my voice box, and I'm sure destroyed all your eardrums. Anyway, thanks for watching this, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.